Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. Google announced this week plans to acquire mobile phone and tablet maker Motorola Mobility for about $12.5 billion. Motorola Mobility exclusively ships phones and its Zoom tablet with Google's Android operating system. The deal will mean that Google now has a hardware manufacturer to work closely with to develop Android. Google will also have control of Motorola's impressive patent portfolio of more than 24,000 patents. We asked an analyst whether the deal will strain the relationship that Google has with other companies that ship Android devices.
One of the things that these companies have to think about is how much advanced knowledge and advanced capabilities will Motorola, under Google's ownership, have with Android versus what they get. Will Motorola have more access, faster access, earlier access to the Android source code as it advances and evolves? Thus far, from what we can tell from the deal, that's technically not going to happen because Motorola will be run as a separate unit, and Google has told us that they are that all of their licensees are fine with the acquisition, but it certainly does raise a few eyebrows.
CEO Larry Page confirmed that Motorola's patent portfolio is part of the reason why Google opened its wallet, saying our acquisition of Motorola will increase competition by strengthening Google's patent portfolio, which will enable us to better protect Android from anti-competitive threats from Microsoft, Apple, and other companies. Samsung is again free to sell its Android-based Galaxy Tab 10.1 in all European Union countries except Germany. A court in Dusseldorf changed its injunction enacted last week because of uncertainties about jurisdiction. A spokesperson at the district court said that it wasn't clear whether the court can forbid a company based in Korea from selling its products in countries other than Germany. On Tuesday, the court said that while Samsung GmbH, the company's German affiliate, may not sell Galaxy Tabs outside Germany, Samsung Korea can. The injunction last week came as a result of Apple claiming that Samsung's tablet is a copy of its iPad. The U.S. Federal Communications Commission is looking into last week's shutdown of mobile phone services on a San Francisco commuter train line. The Bay Area Rapid Transit District, or BART, pulled the plug on mobile phone-based stations in an attempt to disrupt a planned protest. The outage lasted about 3 hours. The planned protest last week didn't materialize, but this week it did. On Monday, a group of 50 to 100 protesters forced BART to shut down station after station in San Francisco's downtown. This time, though, BART didn't shut down the underground mobile base stations operated by 5 wireless carriers. Members of the hacking collective Anonymous joined up with Bay Area activists to protest last month's killing of a passenger who was shot by a BART policeman after throwing a knife at the officer. In gaming news this week, Microsoft said its Xbox 360 outsold competing game consoles in the U.S. for the 7th straight month in July. The company said it had sold more than 275,000 units during the month, giving it a 45% share of the current generation of game boxes, which includes Sony's PlayStation 3 and Nintendo's Wii. The Xbox 360 has been lifted by the success of its Kinect platform, a motion-sensing device that lets users play games through physical movements. The overall game market in the U.S. was down 26% from a year earlier. The 40% price cut on Nintendo's 3DS has caused sales of the handheld console to soar in Japan. The gaming device had its best 7-day run of sales since its launch in February, selling more than 200,000 units. How adventurous of an app user are you? If you're using apps past the top 10 in the Android market, then you're bucking the trend, according to a new Nielsen study. The top 10 Android apps claim about 43% of the average user's daily time. Android users also spend about an hour every day accessing the web and using their apps on their handsets. Comparative data with iPhone users wasn't available. A biped robot developed by DARPA and students at the University of Michigan has been programmed to sprint at varying speeds and move in the same way that humans can. It can run at an average speed of 4.4 miles per hour with a top speed of 6.8. That's about 10 kilometers per hour. Called Mabel, its body weighs 65 kilograms or about 143 pounds, and it could probably run faster if it was slimmed down. It's also quite loud. We've seen a number of biped robots, including the famous Petman from Boston Dynamics. Like its cousin Big Dog, Petman too can keep itself stable when pushed. With all this research on biped robots, it's likely only a matter of time before we see humanoid robots walking down the street with us. MIT researchers are working on improving operations on aircraft carriers and taking an antiquated system into the 21st century. For decades, the Navy has been using something they call the Ouija board to move aircraft and supplies around the deck of huge floating airports. Researchers at MIT are hoping they can digitize that system, make it more efficient, and reduce any chance for error.
It's Navy-funded research that primarily is investigating how humans and computers can work together schedule operations on the aircraft carrier deck collaboratively. So rather than being just a human or just a computer to do it, how we can get them to work together and really use their own strengths in order to create better, more efficient, and safer schedules of operation.
The DCAP system will keep track of equipment and people on deck using RFID. Whoever's in charge of scheduling can move aircraft forward or backwards in the schedule, and the entire system will adjust. It will also reschedule operations should one of the catapults that launches aircraft stop working. The research team built a small-scale model of an aircraft carrier with moving models, all controlled by the DCAP system. Ryan said he doesn't imagine a system like DCAP going into operation for about a decade because it will need to be tested to work flawlessly under both a controlled environment and in wartime. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. Tune in next time as we take a look at an app that pairs you with green transport in a city near you. Find out what's coming up on every week's show by following us on Facebook and Twitter. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.